Hello everybody, welcome back. Balu here from SPTech Bangalore. Today we are going to deal with the last part of this particular video series on how to execute the academic projects. If you have not subscribed for this particular channel, please subscribe it now for more video series on various subjects related to technology. Now I'll just take you through the session recap of what we have done so far. So far we have actually covered how to create project documents in relevance to how to create a cover page. We saw how to create a bona fide certificate. We saw a declaration, acknowledgement, list of figures, table of contents, introduction, synopsis, business requirement document, software requirement specification, and software design document. Today we shall see some of the last and conclusive part of your project report documents in terms of software implementation and testing. Now, software implementation testing will have two things, two chapters in your project report. One is called the tools and technologies, and the second would be on system testing. And the last one would be your conclusion and references. See, under system testing, you would be having the testing methodology and test case report. Now, this is the simple cycle of, you know, how we have come through the various stages of project development so far. So first we had the business requirement document. Now this business requirement document became an input for preparing a software requirement specification. The software requirement specification document became an input for software design document. Now this software design document will be actually implemented in the form of a computer program, which we call it as coding. Now once the coding is done using any of the programming languages, this code will be actually tested, which is called as software testing. And once the software testing is successfully completed, we shall hand over the entire software to the customers, and the customers will perform one more level of testing there. It is called as user acceptance testing. And once the user acceptance testing is completed successfully by a customer, then we say that the project has come to an end, and then the entire project goes on a maintenance mode. So now, when you are talking about system implementation, you are supposed to write one chapter in your project report on system implementation. So system implementation basically means converting the system design document into the actual working model or the actual working software. Now to write a software, you need various things. You need programming languages, you need technologies, libraries and frameworks, you need IDE, that is your integrated development environment. You need databases, you need networking protocols and data security. Now, I have taken example of online banking throughout this particular video series. So if you want to develop this online banking, what are the tools and techniques and libraries you require, and what are the programming languages you require? Now, in the case of programming languages, you can actually develop this particular application either using Java are using C sharp. If you are using Java, then you are going to use Eclipse as an IDE, and you are going to use MySQL or Oracle as your database, and you are going to select some internet protocols like TCP/IP, HTTP, HTTPS, etc. So that means now these four columns are very important part of your project documentation. Now, whenever you are basically developing a project and you are actually writing a software for a particular customer, you have to basically select among these things. I have only given few examples here, but there are so many things which can be appended into this particular list. Select the programming language, select the technology library, select your IDE and databases, and write few paragraphs about what exactly you have selected, and write a few paragraphs about what is that technology and what is that framework. You don't have to write notes of on all these things pages by pages. You just have to write few paragraphs about the framework, technology, database, IDE, networking protocols and data security. Now once you are done with this particular system implementation chapter, the next good thing you need to understand here is most of the students have this particular doubt. Should I or should I not include printout of programs in my project report? Now, printout of programs, they generally include in a section called coding. So what students basically do is they create a chapter called coding, and they take printout of all the programs and incorporate that in the project report. When you do that, your project report becomes very, very, very bulky. So now, whether should I include coding or not, if to answer this particular question, you need to talk to your HOD and an internal guide. If your HOD says that you have to actually include coding because that has become a practice by the seniors and all our college project report will have coding incorporated in the project report, please incorporate coding. If your HOD says that do not incorporate coding, do not incorporate. So there is no hard and fast rule that you have to incorporate coding in the project report. So the choice is yours. You need to decide by talking to your management and your internal guide for taking this particular decision. Now, once you perform all these operations in terms of system implementation, the next thing would be is called as system testing. So you have to write a chapter on system testing where you are going to clearly specify what are the different kinds of testing you have actually performed on your software. Now, I have taken three types of testing here as an example, and all the three types of testing are put in a solid hierarchy. First, you do unit testing, then you do system testing, then finally you do user acceptance testing. So what you have to do is you have to write a few paragraphs about how exactly you did unit testing. Please do not write notes on unit testing. You have to write how you performed unit testing, how you performed system testing, and how you performed user acceptance testing in relevance to your project. And one of the most important document in system testing is you have to basically create a test case summary report. Now, I am giving you a simple format of a test case summary report. Have a look at this particular format and follow the guidelines. Now, this is an example of a test case summary report for online banking system. Now, here I have taken the test case summary for a login screen. You know that any entry to a software is through a login screen because that was the first requirement given by the customer in the business requirement document, and that was also my first functional specification. So now I am going to create a test case summary for how do you create for your login screen. Now here you can see here, now this test case summary will have certain sections here. I would rather say in terms of columns. So here you have serial number, you have BRD section, you have functional specification section, you have a test case, you have a check item, you have an objective, you have steps to execute, you have expected result, and you have test result. Now, I have given the BRD section as 1.0. You remember, this BRD section is a business requirement document section which came from my system requirement specification or software requirement specification. That BRD section 1.0 had the functional specification 1.0 where it was nothing but to basically create a login screen. Now, functional specification 1.0 was to basically specify to create a login screen, and I am writing test cases. That is TC001 to TC004. All these four test cases are only used to check for a login screen. Now, what is the first test case I am going to write? So, TC001, I am going to check item. Under the check item, I am writing login screen user interface. That means I am going to check for the login screen user interface. Now, this is my login screen user interface. As you can see, if you can recall, this login screen user interface was actually documented in software design document, which was figure 6.0. That is why I have written here as reference figure 6.0 from software design document. So I need to check this. Now, what is the meaning of checking this login screen? I need to check whether this login screen has been properly implemented or not. So, what is the objective of this particular test case, TC001? I need to actually check for login screen user interface. That is my check item. And I have to check all text boxes and buttons. That means I have to check for this particular text box username and for the text box password, and I have to check for the button OK and cancel whether they have been aligned properly or not as per the prototype defined in the software design document. Now, once I do that, I am going to get an expected result. What is the expected result? UI should be perfect. That means I am expecting a result that whatever UI I am testing, it should be as per the prototype, and text boxes and buttons has to be aligned properly. So this is as per the prototype. Now I need to really give the result of this particular test case, whether it has passed or failed. Now I have taken it as passed. That means this particular test case has past. Now, what is the meaning of that? That the login screen has actually been programmed and implemented as per the software design document. Now, once you say that login screen user interface has been implemented properly, it does not mean that the login screen is working properly. So for that, I write different test cases. Now here, I am going to write a test case where I am going to check for invalid username and invalid password, and I am going to give invalid username and invalid password for the steps to execute. Now, when I give invalid username and invalid password and hit on the OK button, what should generally happen? It should display me a relevant message that it is an invalid username and an invalid password. So the message has been displayed. So I have given the test result as pass. Similarly, I am giving a valid username and valid password. If I give a valid username and valid password, then the system should log in. So it should log in with a relevant message, to be precise. So now you can see what is the expected result. System must log in with relevant message. The expected result has come for me. So I give the test result as pass. And finally, I also had mentioned in the software requirement specification in terms of bad login attempts. That means if 3 or 4 times if the attempts were actually invalid, then I think your entire application should be locked. So I'm going to even test for that. So track for bad login attempts. I'm going to give invalid username and invalid password for 3 consecutive attempts. So system should get locked, and here the system is actually getting locked. So I say that the test result has passed. So what does this mean? All the test cases, that is 001 to 004, have successfully passed. That means all my functional specification has been implemented successfully, which has actually come from the business requirement document, which is actually defined by the customer. So this is how I write a test case summary for my login screen. Like that, you have to write test case summary for to check balance, test case summary to check fund transfer, and test case summary to order for a checkbook. Whatever functional specifications you have actually defined in your software requirement specification, for all those functional specification defined in SRS, you have to write the relevant test case summary. And in most of the project report I review, I don't find this test case summary, which is actually a very important and vital documentation of your project report. Now, this completes the testing chapter of your project report. Once you have completed the testing chapter, the next thing would be to write the conclusion chapter of your project report. Now, what is the conclusion chapter of your project report and what does it contain? It is one of the most powerful chapter of your project report because the conclusion gives the complete overview of the work what you have done. So you need to ensure that you keep the conclusion short and simple. Do not write conclusion more than one page. Generally, a conclusion should be limited to one paragraph or maximum 2 paragraphs. That conclusion should basically contain the summary of the entire project in the bulleted points. If somebody reads the conclusion, they should be able to actually understand the entire project, the highlighted features of that particular project. And it is very important for software projects to ensure that you are going to write future enhancements in your conclusion. Now, your project is online banking. That's the example what I have taken here. So you need to ensure what are the future enhancements of your online banking. Now, there are some features which you have already programmed in online banking. So future enhancement, what are the additional features you are going to give in terms of security, in terms of performance, or now it is just an web application. For example, in the next version of online banking, you may even thrive for going for a mobile app. So that would be one of your future enhancements. So ensure that you write a very powerful conclusion, and that is one of the chapters of your project report. And the last chapter would be your references. Now, references are very important because when you want to develop a project, you need huge knowledge repository. You need technical resources from the internet. You need book resources from the library. You need consulting from another people who are actually subject matter experts in that particular area. So in that case, you have to write down the list of references which you have actually seen through in order to execute this particular project and documenting the project report. So now the references would be the last chapter of your project report. Now once you have finished the references, that concludes all the documents of your project report. I'll just once again take you through what are the documents of the project report once again. So first you did the cover page with a project title, then you saw a bona fide certificate, then you wrote a declaration, then we saw how to write an acknowledgement, list of figures, table of contents, introduction, synopsis, business requirement document, software requirement specification, software design document, system implementation, system testing, conclusion and references. So all these would actually make a complete project report, a professional project report. So if you can create a report of this particular sort, then there is no doubt that you are going to get good marks in your project, and more importantly, you will have a satisfaction that you have actually done a live project on your own. So this completes my video series on how to execute final semester academic projects. I will also see you again in my new video series on database management system shortly. Till then, goodbye. But please don't forget to subscribe to my channel SPTech and like me on my Facebook page. And don't forget to leave your comments below on how you felt about this particular video series. Thank you once again, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Yeah.